Hi, my name's Tim, and I study landscape architecture and urban design at the University of California, Berkeley. For part of my studies, I had the chance to go to a city that changed the way I think about the environment. I took a video camera with me, and this is the story of what I found.
On the oceans and upon our seas, fish full of mercury. Oh, oh, mercy, mercy me. Oh, things ain't what they used to be. Radiation.
We know we're facing an environmental crisis. We can picture it. Every day we're presented with images of traffic, pollution, or toxic waste. But what about the solutions to these problems? What do they look like? When we think about environmental success, it's one thing to think of a clear mountain stream or an old-growth forest. But what about urban ecological solutions? We just don't think of cities as healthy environments, but they can be. I went to a city where environmental solutions happen every day. Curitiba, Brazil is a city of 1.6 million people, about the same population as Denver, Portland, or Kansas City. It's the capital of the state of Paraná, and it's located inland, 3,000 feet above sea level. Brazil is a country of many big cities, and most of them have their share of urban problems. But Curitiba seems to be an exception. In fact, it's known as the ecological capital of Brazil. I went there to find out, what does an ecological city look like?
O é que ela fazia, o que ele dizia. O é que ela fazia, o que ele dizia. Era moqueca de siri
que eles tanto comiam.
Era moqueca de siri
que eles tanto comiam.
Tinha uma pimenta que tanto ardia.
The first place I visited in Curitiba was the Research and Urban Planning Institute, or EPUC. EPUC is a busy place where people from different backgrounds work together. Architects, landscape architects, engineers, transportation planners, and administrators all collaborate to help plan the city. Liana Valicelli is the supervisor of information at EPUC.
Okay, well, EPUC is the institute responsible for the urban planning of the city of Curitiba. It started in December 65, more than 30 years ago, as a recommendation of the master plan that was developed in 65. The master plan said there should be a group for detailing and implementing this master plan. And so started the book in December here in this house. And now we are more than 200 people working for the city.
The 1965 master plan set out to enhance the quality of urban life for the people of Curitiba. It established some priorities, like directing growth, increasing parkland, and improving public transportation. These priorities continue to guide the development of the city today. The city controls its growth by setting boundaries. These boundaries are large parks, which separate Curitiba from its neighbors. City parks are managed by the Municipal Secretary for the Environment. Alfredo Vicente de Castro Trinidade is one of the department's managers.
Okay, well, the park system has some small stories to tell. We had, on the 70s on Curitiba, lots of problems with the floods. They decided to get an area which the basin was very low and we had some communities living there. We removed those communities and decided to build a lake on this area. Why the lake? The idea with the lake is that when the water came with the flood, it would get to the lake and it would slow down their speed and would have area enough to spread so it could be contained, at least in part. Then when it got to the end, it goes could flow again easily. So kind of concentrating where you had your flood. So how you're going to do this and have people living around? You couldn't. So we decided to make a park. It was usually called the linear park because it follows the line of the river. And it worked. It was with the price of canalizing, let's say, 100 meters. Normally, you could use this money and build an entire park 500 times larger than just those 100 square meters. And it worked just fine.
From up here, it's easy to see how the park separates Curitiba on this side from its neighbors on the other side. Not only did the 1965 master plan recommend that the growth of Curitiba be contained by a greenbelt of parks, but it also defined linear corridors of development called structural axes radiating from the downtown. Along these structural axes are high-rise apartment buildings that are served by the main lines of the bus system. The center lanes are set aside for buses only, giving first priority to the public transportation system. The best place to see the results of this plan is from the top of the Telepar Tower. From here, a clear line of high-rise buildings visually illustrates the border between the intense development of the structural axes and the low-density neighborhoods of houses, trees, and parks in between. The radiating axes converge in the city center. The way downtown Curitiba itself was preserved as a place for people is now a local legend. A plan called for an automobile overpass through the center of the city, which would have destroyed the downtown. Instead, the mayor sent a team of construction workers to build a street not for cars, but for pedestrians.
In 72, when Mayor Lerner started to implement the pedestrian street in downtown, it was a mess. There was a problem. The owners of the shops of the central city, the central street, they didn't want to have the cars removed of the street. They were afraid to lose the clients. On Friday night, the machines, the public work started and was completed. Two blocks were completed in 2 days. So when the shops opened on Monday morning, everything was done.
Motorists were furious and organized a parade of cars to reclaim the street. But when they arrived, city workers blocked them by unrolling long sheets of paper and inviting children to paint. Every Saturday morning, this event is remembered in what's now a downtown devoted to people, not cars.
The people started to understand day by day that this was an attraction for the shops. The pedestrian area was an attraction. So in the following years, and still today, the owners of the shops of other areas of the city, they come here and ask, when are you going to develop a new pedestrian street in my neighborhood or here and there? So I don't know, I don't mean that now it's easy, it's easier. So when we want to implement a new project, the people trust in the public sector. This is very important, that, because generally in other cities, this does not happen.
What are the best things about taking the bus in Curitiba? Well, I think the public transportation makes it easy to go anywhere. You can go any place. It's a practical, fast system, especially the silver speedy buses. I really like them. They're the buses I like the most. And the neighborhood buses. They're all important. I really like them.
Too bad there aren't more buses. They're also crowded. But they're great. The bus system in Curitiba is first world.
The ease with which you can take a bus from one neighborhood to another with a single fare. You can practically circle the entire city with a single fare. It's an integrated system.
Do you always take the bus?
Always. I never go any other way.
Is it easier than going by car?
Much easier. To come downtown especially, it is much easier by bus. There aren't any places to park a car around here.
You can build a city for the car. You must build a city for people. That's it.
Carlos Seneviva is president of ERBS, the agency responsible for transportation planning in Curitiba.
Myself, I'm an architect. I was president in PUC several years ago. My staff, my team, it's all people who came of the same, you can say the same school of urban planning. And all this began on the 70s in Ipuki. We talk all the same language, and we have all the same goal, a good city.
A big part of what makes Curitiba a good ecological city are its buses. Along with other components of the master plan, the bus system is an integral part of a better, more accessible city.
We don't see transportation like a specialty. The transportation network is a tool of urban planning. Okay? So, all the city was planned mainly based in these three tools, the transportation, the street system, and the land use.
This coordinated planning has allowed the city to grow hand in hand with its bus system. In 1974, when the population of Curitiba was 600,000, one bus line served the entire city. In the 70s and 80s, as the population tripled, the bus network expanded to meet growing demand. Today, the entire system is integrated to allow passengers to transfer between lines and to get wherever they need to go easily, quickly, and inexpensively.
Metros or subways networks, they are good not because they are metros or subways. They are good because they are network. Okay, so here we have a network all operated by buses, but the concept is the same.
I'm at a bus stop in a neighborhood about 10 miles outside of the center of the city. From here, I can catch a local bus that will take me to a station where I can transfer to the main line, or I can catch another bus to any other part of the city, all for a single fare of about 55 cents.
The people in the bus go up and down, up and down, up and down. The people in the bus go up and down, all around the town. There's a break in the bus, goes rump, 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 crash. There's a break in the bus, goes rump, 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 all around the town. There's a wiper in the bus.
Today, two-thirds of the citizens of Curitiba use buses every day. Researchers estimate that this saves 27 million automobile trips and the corresponding amount of fuel each year. Public transportation is good for the environment, and it's very inexpensive. In fact, Curitiba's system is 1/300th the price of what it would have been to build a metro.
We can think in more sophisticated systems, like metros or tramways, but they are very, very expensive. It's impossible to us to build a network of metro, of subway, at this moment, perhaps in the future. But now, we must work with buses. But we can make the bus something better with some innovations.
In 1991, Curitiba introduced a very simple but brilliant innovation. Tube stations are elevated glass bus stops where passengers pay their fare, enter through a turnstile, then board at bus level. With the reduced loading and unloading time, buses tripled the number of passengers they carry each hour. Riders save an average of 15 minutes in travel time going to work.
Próxima parada, estação Holanda. Desembarque pelas portas 2 e 4.
The tube stations are good not only because they're efficient, but also because they make the system more attractive to use. A survey found that 1 month after implementing the tube stations, 28% of the people riding the bus had previously driven their cars to work.
Well, this is something natural. People are proud of the city. If the city is good, they are proud of the transportation system, if the system is good, and they know if it's good. We don't need to say it. We must offer a good system, and people understand if the system is good or not. The judgment is free.
So the secretary really had a great impact on the city by changing how people saw environment. We gave them an option of a program and they saw the results, so they start to trust our work. And with this we opened several other projects helping the city. You know, the project Garbage Which Is Not Garbage won a prize from the United Nations. And of course this was put on television and everywhere. And people were very proud because it wasn't a city hall program. It was a program from the city. Everybody took part. Each person which separated the garbage on his house felt proud when the city got the prize. It was if they were getting something, a recognition for their work. That was very important. No, the main idea is that you separate on your house glass, plastic, paper and metal. So you put this in the different bags. And the garbage which is not garbage is collected by a special truck. It's not a compactor truck. It's an open truck, a normal one. And it has a similarity, it's the bell. They ring a bell on the bus so you can hear when you're in your house and know that special collection is going to pass in front of your house. And this material goes to a simple plant that we have far from the city, where it's manually separated and prepared to be resold.
I think it's very important. Sometimes people don't value recycling, but I think it's important for all cities to do it. Imagine how much waste would be reduced. Fewer trees would be cut. The entire environmental balance would be better.
Oh, I love trash! Anything dirty or dingy or dusty!
The award-winning recycling program is another reason Curitiba is the ecological capital of Brazil. Recycling garbage is not the exception, it's the rule. 90% of the population separates their garbage. Simple, effective solutions to environmental problems are found everywhere in Curitiba.
Some time ago, we had a problem to collect the garbage in areas which didn't have an infrastructure installed, so the truck couldn't come in these areas to pick the garbage. And so we were having problems of these guys throwing this garbage on rivers or empty spaces. So we had to do something. What we decided is that we would contact the leadership of this village and ask him if people would put this garbage in a bag and bring to a special place that he would determine. We would come with the truck and collect all together at once. Of course, we had to give something to get this. They wouldn't do this just for environmental corrections, let's say. So we had to have something to give. So we saw that we were having an accident of production of vegetables in the metropolitan region. And these farmers were throwing away the production because they couldn't get a price to sell it in the market. So we came in and paid them at least something, not the marketplace, market price, but some money for that production. We would bring this, prepare a small bag containing carrots, lettuce, this kind of vegetables, some rice, some beans, and we would change with these people for their garbage, so a 5 kilos bag for a small bag of vegetables. So we helped two different people, the farmers, which were starving, let's say, because they couldn't sell their production. And we helped those very poor communities that you couldn't take out the garbage. With this collection garbage, we diminished a lot health problems on those regions. And we gave them a different idea of carbon and gave them, so we could really start to talk to them about saving the environment, because how can you talk about someone about saving the environment if this guy doesn't have anything to wear, to eat? He won't care about it. So we had a way to get inside the community and talk with them.
For a city to be truly ecological, it must also teach its citizens about their role in the environment.
Well, as I told you, people come here and change.
This is the Free University for the Environment, a school where ecological issues are taught to the public.
Built in an old stone quarry, it's made of recycled telephone poles. Cleon Ricardo dos Santos is the director.
The building seems to rise from the earth and very linked with the general landscape. It's a very good solution. The idea is to have a kind of architecture very linked to nature, and you can see the results. The Open University for the Environment is not a formal university. We have some courses, short courses in different fields, all of them linked with urban environmental management. We are aware that people is really interested in this kind of programs, but they don't know how to do things. Normally we give them an idea about what the environment is. Then he can notice that the program. But garbage that is not garbage is not only a program created to be cute, but has environmental importance. Then he links things in their heads. But you cannot say you do this or that thing. You give them an idea, and he will think about and he will change.
Baby, there is nothing like your own. You don't have to do all the burning books. Revolutionize at home.
Yeah, that's what we try to do, to sensibilize these people and to understand why that's important. It doesn't matter, just say don't cut the tree. You have to say why not to cut the tree, why not to throw the garbage away. So that's the line we try to follow. We try to enlighten the population. We respect them very much, and we try to explain them why don't do wrong things.
Because we are not planning in a closed room without going outside, going to the city, going to the neighborhood. We go every day to the neighborhood. Every day we are studying how to improve the quality of this project, of this program, the quality of life of the city. So we are in permanent contact with the city.
The current mayor of Curitiba is Rafael Greca. He's an incredibly busy man. During his term in office, Greca has focused on strengthening the social programs of the city and has helped initiate hundreds of projects. He's a jolly character, bursting with energy and enthusiasm for his city, and he's adored by the people of Curitiba. I caught up with the mayor at a celebration for senior citizens.
Here in Curitiba, we are looking for social justice. And social justice is a fruit of a hard work of social welfare. This is the Citizenship Street in the popular quartier of Fazendinha. And here we are working with the ancient people to do this social welfare and this social justice.
Helping the mayor is his wife, Dona Margarita. She's the president of FAS, the Social Action Foundation, which manages the city's social programs.
Here in Curitiba, we are working to create opportunities for all the people, for the elder people like here today, for young people, for everybody, for those who want to work and they don't know how to work. So we give classes to them.
Classes Curitiba style means accessible, relevant, affordable courses that teach people skills so they can contribute to the city. One program that does this is the Liceu program, which offers courses like cooking, sewing, or hairdressing. Students are often recent immigrants from the countryside who need job training to work in the city. To make the courses as available as possible, the city builds houses in growing neighborhoods and converts them into schools. People can walk to their classes, and because the liceos are in their communities, they feel comfortable about learning. The 3-month courses are worth the tuition. To learn to be a mechanic, computer programmer, or chef cost about $4.
Good morning, little school girl. Good morning, little school girl. Till I come home.
In the poorest neighborhoods, the city started a program called Line to Work, or Linea de Oficio. It's the liceo program, but instead of teaching classes in a house, they're taught in a recycled bus. The bus is driven to a neighborhood, parked for 3 months, and set up as a classroom. One bus can hold many classes a day, maybe typing 1 hour and a manicure class the next. In the 4 years these programs have existed, they've trained over 100,000 people to be part of the job force of Curitiba. Mayor Greca is also involved in public education. He designed a series of textbooks to teach children about their city.
A student receives the textbook, Lessons of Curitiba at School, with the purpose that he or she will get a better education. And the students also visit various places in the city. For example, they visit the Botanical Garden. So they're going to learn about these cultural attractions that they visit, and the lesson is combined with all the other subjects taught in the classroom. So when they go on a field trip, they have already studied the place. It's an oriented visit. And also, each student will become more and more critical, understanding why things are the way they are. So the students will have a lot to contribute, not only criticize, but also change, so that we have a better world, or in our case, a better city, a better Curitiba.
So we try to say we are a normal city with the same budget as other cities, but we managed to do a lot of things for the city.
Curitiba is a normal city, but its creative solutions emphasizing people and the environment make this ordinary city extraordinary. And as it grows faster than any other place in Brazil, some of these solutions have allowed Curitiba to deal with one of its greatest pressures, the demand for housing. Brazil has a problem with favelas, squatter settlements that form when a city's unprepared for quick growth. To avoid this, Curitiba planners created programs to involve new immigrants in the organized construction of their houses and communities. The street offers a different kind of model home. Here, each house demonstrates a different kind of environmentally friendly building construction. Residents from this neighborhood can come and find out about these techniques and then use them to build their own houses. Another program architecturally solves two urban issues: housing and jobs. The villas do oficio are modeled after medieval trade villages, where people worked on the bottom floor and lived on the top.
Well, I've had the opportunity to come live in the Villa do Oficio, a project of our city government. I think it is excellent because they're also giving me the chance to start my own business. In my case, the business is a video rental store. So I have a chance to develop this business. Come on, I'll show you my place.
A família mora aqui, né? É um espaço. Aqui mora.
The family lives here. Me, my wife, my two little kids, and my sister-in-law. So here we have the domestic space. I was given the freedom to expand, so what's going to happen here? I'm going to add more space below for the business. I'm going to add more space for the family, and also I'm going to build more bedrooms on top, you know. So I can build out to here, and I'm going to add on a little more. I used to rent. I never had a house. Now I've been given the chance. It's small, it's modest, but now I have the opportunity to develop a business, and me and my family have a place that's going to be ours.
Curitiba also strengthens neighborhoods with projects that put municipal resources into the community.
The citizen streets are a new set of projects that bring all the services of City Hall to the neighborhoods.
Here you can register your car, look for a job, get an ID. Eventually, there will be 7 of these facilities, one in each major district of the city.
Not only do the Ruas de Cidadania make services more convenient for people, but they also cut down on the amount of traffic traveling into the city center.
Of course, each citizenship street has a bus station that connects it to the rest of the public transportation system. Another very successful project created during Mayor Greca's term has been the Farol do Saber, or Lighthouse of Learning.
So, hi everybody, my name is Silvana, and I work to the first computerized library here in Curitiba. Each library is called Lighthouse Library, you know, because the architecture reminds you of a lighthouse, is that right? And each one has kind of 3,000-4,000 books. But here in the city's lighthouse, as we call the library, we try to make a different thing. Instead of offering books to the community, we try to offer computers, right? A good thing about a library is that everything here is free, as you can see around. I know that in California, you know, 100% of the population have access to to the computers, have, you know, a computer at home. But we do not have this in Brazil. It does not happen here. And the purpose here is to approximate kids, you know, and even the community to these computers, you know, because lots of kids who come here mainly to deal with city rooms over there, they do not have computer at home, and they do not have computers in schools to deal, you know. Just let me show some things that we are using here. This is the only Portuguese encyclopedia we have in city rooms. It's called Almanac Abril, right? The guys here are trying to get access to some information about the kind of theaters, museums, parks that we have here in the city. Oh, this is what I want to show you, the history and the tourist attractions of the city. Then you just choose what you want to see. You have just to touch the screen and to follow what is said in the phone, in your headphones. And then you choose the tourist attraction you want to go.
Everywhere you look in Curitiba, there's information about the city. Making the city understandable is an important part of making it ecological. This is done in many ways. There's a line in the cobblestone that runs through downtown. You can walk this line and pass historic buildings, murals, and signs explaining the colorful architecture. There are also information signs at many of the tourist attractions, describing how each city program contributes to making Curitiba a better place to live. Up in the Telepar Tower, people can orient themselves with a map on the floor, then look out the window to get a sense of where they are. Videos about Curitiba also promote the ecological capital of Brazil. The citizens of Curitiba are provided with abundant information about their city. Television commercials explain the bus system, and newspapers feature stories about new city projects. Curitiba is a city that takes pride in being a city, and even more. Curitiba knows that healthy urban life is a vital part of the future of the global environment.
But Curitiba has another feature. Has, the people of Curitiba, the really Curitibanos, they are interested in their city. They are there is a real interest in this city. My mother calls me today to say, look, this street has garbage there. What you are doing in this city, you know?
Ludomir Fashensky is now Secretary of Urbanism for the State of Parana. He's been part of the Curitiba team of planners that's transformed the city since the 1960s.
On the 60s, the university opened the School of Architecture. It was a very important moment for Curitiba. Curitiba there was a city with 600,000, 700,000 people. But we were really afraid of the future. We were noticing what was going in São Paulo and other big cities in Brazil, and we would like to avoid this in Curitiba. Eventually, some of the architects that were in this group, like Mr. Lerner, they went to the IPUC and continued to develop the IPUC. In 71, Mr. Lerner was appointed mayor. So he came from the PUC with all these plans, really. He eventually invited me to go to the PUC. And he said, well, we have a plan, we have projects, let's go.
If Curitiba were a kingdom, Jaime Lerner would be king. He's been mayor 3 times, and he's widely considered to be the leader responsible for making Curitiba the city it is today. As proof that giving priority to the environment's politically popular, Mr. Lerner's now governor of the state of Paraná.
We never wanted to have all the answers, because sometimes if you want to have all the answers, you're postponing the possibility to intervene. So, never try. I'm realizing that in many cities in the world, and in many universities, people, they don't want to take risks. They want all the answers before starting. So you have, sometimes we have to start, and the starting is important. And you can always correct the itinerary.
The important thing in the cities is not to discuss about cities, do something for the cities, you know? This is the important thing. And we show this, I think the main features in Curitiba. You know, I'm not discussing if it's the best solution or not. What I'm saying, that the important thing in Curitiba is that we did the things at a relatively low price. It was only the political decision of a group of people to do the things, and we did it.
You know, it's hard to achieve an individual dream. And more difficult it's to achieve a collective dream, because ambitions of from one to the other, we have different needs, different ambitions. So to achieve a collective dream, we have to organize a shared cause. I remember during a discussion at MIT, I had this question. So, okay, Curitiba is okay, but how to make it happen? So I don't know. It's every country, we have different institutional, we are different, but if I could say in a very simple way, it's to make it happen, it's to propose a scenario or an idea or a project or that everyone or the big majority of the city, they understand it is important, and they'll help you to make it happen. This, it's what I feel, it's a shared cause. If you can organize, if you can propose this, if the people can understand their shared cause, so you can change the city.
Curitiba's shared course makes it a concrete example of urban environmental success. Its solutions are not universal. A city should respond to its own particular needs and conditions. But the lesson of Curitiba is that any city can be ecological.
One more question.
Okay.
What does an ecological city look like?
Like Curitiba.
It may seem a million miles away, but it gets a little closer every day. It may seem a million miles away, but it gets a little closer every day. It may seem a million miles away, but it gets a little closer every day.
You can make important changes in every city in the world in less than 2 years. The more you act locally, you understand that the possibility of change is in your hand. And if every city could make important changes, you can change the whole society.
Depois de 9 meses você vê o resultado. Depois de 9 meses você...